main streets on the market. This is the not roofed, and there's the roofed on the other side. Small alleys connect them two. Not too big, but it draws a lot of people in here. I think because of the light rail, before they started doing the light rail and after it, they measured, it clicked how many people in and out from the market. You know the clicker?
Yes.
They were standing people with a clicker. In Friday and holiday, Jewish holiday times, it's around 80,000 people a day.
Wow.
A day. Okay. 80,000. It's huge.
Where do you buy your spices? Somewhere in the market?
I'll show you where exactly. Abba, אפשר להיכנס לצלם? Please. This shop specializes in tahini, which is made from sesame seeds, Ethiopian sesame seeds. And they have the rhinestone, which resembles the way of making a tahini. I think, I'm positive, that this rhinestone is not making all of the tahini. It's only for...
I know, for sure.
I'm positive about it. It's only for touristical purposes and to demonstrate it, but it's really cool. And it's
but they still grind, they
it does.
Right?
Yeah, it does.
Just not all the supply, yeah. It's very smooth.
Yes.
It's smooth on the tongue. It's not chalky.
Because it's a cold press. It's a crucial part of making hummus, for example. It's a crucial part from almost every meal. As a dip, as a salad. You see all the boxes, everything is flavored tahini. Some is natural. This is chocolate tahini. This is with chili peppers. This is with date honey. This is with carobs. This is with amba. With another chili, with hazelnut, coriander. חבר'ה, תודה רבה.
תודה רבה. בוא, מדהים. בוא. מדהים וטעים. So, I love this market.
Around 90%, 95% is local Israeli of the ingredients in the market.
Okay.
95%. Some of the ingredients would come from Palestinian cities, some would come from Israeli cities. It's the most political, non-political place in the world. מה קורה, אבא? מה שלומך?
מה לפרק אותם?
This is איבגי.
היי, איבגי.
נתי.
עיניו.
נתי. נתי, this shop here, it's around 70 years, Delhi. People going back to small producers, to organic producers, what you would call heirloom products, okay? We call it organic baladi.
Yeah,
heirloom is the same. And it's really the flavors of our area, of our terroir, the Levant.
Yes.
This is the example of how doing it in a worldwide movement of going to farm to table, going to the soil, how it affected us in Israel.
Uri, my team here asked me what is the Levant? Because we heard this terminology so often
Levant.
In the past few days.
We are
right?
All Levantines.
Yes.
So the Levant is the area of the Middle East, which we are living. So it's, as I know, understand it, it's from Egypt, Israel, Lebanon, all this area, up until, I think, Jordan, stuff like that. This area is the Levant.
And what
it's called Khushkash, you know?
Khushkash, yes. It's the, this is the indigenous orange, and probably the grandfather of all the common oranges that we have now.
We do a small chaser, small shot of arak, and we continue.
Toda. Thank you. Cheers. Gilush.
Wow, matok.
Wow.
Wow. Wow. Nice and sweet, huh?
Zakhlawi.
From Lebanon. Po konim, konim. את מה שהם סובבים סביבו. אני רוצה להכיר לך את עיניו, חברה טובה מאמריקה.
שלום, זמיר.
וקיסטן, הוא הצלם.
This is the original Pereg spices, fourth generation already.
נכון.
No additives, just the pure spices.
אני רוצה שתראה להם, נדבר גם על זאטר ועל סומק. של תבלינים מקומיים שלנו.
קלויה.
אוקיי.
אנחנו לא שמים.
סומק אתה שם? זה מיקשר של זאטר, סולט, סומק וססמי.
וזאטר זה היסאפ.
זאטר זה היסאפ. זה דרייד, ואז זה בליץ.
בבקשה.
אתה יודע, סומק היה יוזד בלדר אינדסטרי?
כן, לדי.
לא לדי, ל...
עשית ממני פח, אה?
כן, סופטן בלדר. אנחנו עושים סיבוב בשוק, מראים לחבר'ה מאמריקה איזה תותים יפים יש לנו. In Israel, not like in Europe, strawberries are only winter. In our restaurant in London, it's only August. In August, we have strawberries.
And you said the blood orange?
Blood
only
orange
now.
Is only like 5 weeks season.
Uri!
Uri, when you opened Machneyuda,
yes.
That's what you had in mind? The happiness, the vibe?
Yes.
The...
We wanted it to be like a happy place, happy food. Whenever people ask us what food are we going to cook, we always answered happy food. It has to be connected and empowering from the powers of the market. This is why we open a restaurant so close to the market. Because what's going on here, it's crazy. You cannot always see it, you cannot always watch, but the energy and the vibes you get from the market, from the seasonality, from the turning of the holidays, just turning of the days, the year. You get a lot of influence from the market, as I told you before, like 2 months before the networks and the supermarket and the big markets in the center of Israel has it.
Here.
2 months before, it's available here. Why? Because small cars and small trucks, it sounds crazy, but it still works like that. Small cars filled with stuff coming from Bethlehem, from Hebron, from Jericho. Everything's legal and legit, yeah? But this is the first destination they come because this is Jerusalem. It's closest to all of the markets around it, and it's the center of life around it for many years, so it still behaves like that, you know?
It is the capital.
It's a great advantage for us as a restaurant to operate in the capital, not only a political capital, just a culinary capital, you know? Everything comes into Jerusalem from around it. This part of the market is the most beautiful an aesthetic part of the market. All of the shops, all of the vendors really tied and make their stools really neat. And it's working. It's one of the busiest tourist places in the market, this area. This is cardons.
Cardons.
Wild artichoke. Really popular for stuffing. Complicated to do and a lot of fuss. There's a lot of thrones and you're just asking me to be careful. But you have to clean it up really thoroughly. And then you cook it, you fill it maybe with meat or something like that. But look, everything is beautiful. Look at the lettuce, how many kinds of lettuce he has. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 years ago, when you say lettuce in Jerusalem, you will mean this lettuce.
Iceberg or romaine, yeah.
That's it. Now, you have the diversity and the variety is amazing.
But is it because of the demand from restaurants and people?
Yes.
Yep.
Meifa shuit aba? You see, this is from Nimare Latov. This is from Hebron. Tarichi, they smell it. I wish you could smell it. It smells sweet.
Fresh.
Sweet. This is organic. Tamita Park, wow. Wow.
Wow. Now that's sweet. That's great.
Hala, let's go back.
Let's go back. Let's cook something. Toda.
Swell it?
Ah, yeah. The gazia. Yeah?
Sure.
Yeah. Alan.
You see the kerosene stove? Everything is cooked here. And it's been like, they come here 4 a.m. in the morning. 4 a.m.
At night. For me, it's at night.
At night.
Yes.
Everything is cooked daily and fresh. By 4 o'clock, it's empty and this place is closed. Done for the day. And when you come at about 1 o'clock, 12, some of the pots are all already empty and they say, sorry, we're out of. So this is what's cool about it.
You snooze, you lose.
Yeah.
But Uri, what is the big deal about cooking over the kerosene on the gazia?
It's a low temperature and it's long time cooking. And the smell, you smell it? This is the smell of a grandmother house. My grandmother, God bless her soul. This is the smell.
Mine smell from naphthalene. So
you know. You see, that's the difference. So it comes from the principle of kosher, to keep kosher. For example, you turn it on Friday and you turn it and it goes off on Saturday when the kerosene finishes.
Runs out, yeah.